5 o'clock news. Our top stories today.
The World Figure Skating Championships were postponed today after a number of skaters fell over in exactly the same spot during their routines. A British heavyweight boxer has taken the world champion's belt. He also got his trousers, shirt and shoes after sneaking into his changing room. We now go over live to this year's charity marathon, where Patricia Johnson is at the finishing line.
Congratulations, guys. What a staggering effort. 26.2 miles dressed as a donkey. How are you feeling, guys?
Absolutely exhausted.
I bet you are.
This thing weighs a ton.
Yeah, it's a miracle we finished the race at all. I've had a knee problem for a few weeks now. The training's really taken its toll.
But with some extra strapping,
the old knee held up.
But it was for a really good cause, so it was definitely worth it.
What's the cause again?
Well, a donkey sanctuary, obviously.
Of course. How much have you raised?
Over to Rob for that one.
How do you mean?
Well, you were doing the sponsorship.
No, you said you were going to sort that.
The costumes. I said I was going to sort the costume. You were doing the sponsorship forms.
You were going to do them.
It was your job. This is a disaster. We've just run 26 miles for nothing.
It was all right for you. My face was this far away from your bum. And he had a curry last night.
Well, at least I didn't forget to get any sponsorship.
It was your job.
It was your job.
You should have done the sponsorship.
What fun! Back to the studio.
We all love salad, especially if you're keeping an eye on your calories, but it can be an awful lot of bother. So here's a simple shortcut that I use when I know I ought to have salad, but can't be faffed to actually have some. This lettuce, if you look there, is toast that I've dyed green. These tomatoes are actually fried eggs that I've painted red. And these healthy-looking green beans are chips. And the sausage can be, I don't know, peppers or something. There. Basically, most of a fried breakfast. Mm. And that's how to cheat a salad.
Welcome to the Insult Box. And I'm Ian Solent. Here's the fight we've all been waiting for. Low blow McCann taking on this exciting new talent, Rudy Rude Boy Johnson. And there's the bell.
Haven't I seen you on telly, mate? Yeah, your haircut was the greatest ever natural disasters.
Oh, nice opening from Johnson there. You can tell that really hurt McCann.
Nice breath, mate. What you been eating? A dog's bum?
Oh, that one connected as well. Johnson softening him up.
You're just like a superhero. Dressing ladies' tights, no one knows who you are in real life, and you look better wearing a mask.
Oh, nice little combination. This could all be over in seconds.
Your mum's so stupid, she thought an eye patch was a laptop for pirates.
Oh, he's made a mistake there.
Your mum's so stupid, she thinks Hogwarts is a disease for pigs.
He had the fight won, now he's training your mum's with the expert.
Your mum's so old, she babysat for Adam and Eve. Your mum's so old, she went to school in black and white.
That's not going to hurt anyone. Johnson's weakening. I think he's in trouble.
Your mum's so ugly, she escaped from a fire and the fireman carried her back in.
Oh! Oh, my word! That's it! It's all over! Johnson's corner thrown in the towel. McCann remains the undisputed World Insult Boxing Champion.
Sorry, mate, didn't mean it.
I think it's a bit late for that.
I like jacket potatoes, but I don't like trouser potatoes.
Oi! No dive bombing! Have you got any idea how long it took me to blow dry this hair? 2 hours. Be more responsible.
Check it, it's your boy Z_Brash462 kicking it in the kitchen with my top girl, Hillary.
Ninja 567283.
And we're ready to lay down the truth. Check it.
how to wash your trainers.
First of all, we're gonna need a pair of proper rank trainers.
Whoa! Those are totally trashed.
True that. Now it's time for your boy Z_Brash462 to bring the pain to the game.
With a bowl of soapy water and a toothbrush.
What kind of bristles is you sporting on that toothbrush, sis?
Medium soft bristles, bruv.
Just use any old toothbrush.
Yep, I found this next to his bathroom sink.
Whoa!
You said use any old toothbrush.
I said use any old toothbrush.
Any old toothbrush?
Any old. My kicks have been scrubbed up real nice, but I want to get them real nice. There's only one thing for it.
The washing machine.
Boom. Don't just throw them in there, man.
All right, chill out, man.
You're going to want to make sure this bad boy's on the right cycle.
Not too hot.
Not too cold, but just right. Laters. Hillary, pop the hood. What?
Looks like I set the dial too hot, bruv. She get like a dog or something, because these would look fat on a puppy.
Turn off the camera! Turn it off!
Alright.
Alright. It's 5 items or less, love. Hurry up, there's people waiting.
It's 5. Sorry, miss. I can't do rugby today. I've got a nut. I've got a broken toe and I have to keep it elevated.
Yeah, miss, I can't do it either. My knee's a bandy. Look at him!
And now on Radio Fit, guiding you aimlessly through the rest of the athletics, it's our clueless commentators.
You join us here at the, No idea what this is, Helen?
Nope, I am no expert on this, whatever this is.
There are people in shorts. They're bobbing up and down as if they're trying to remember how to do whatever it is this is.
Yes, this certainly does look like it's going to be a thrilling whatever this is. When they start doing it, we haven't missed it, have we?
Just a minute. There's a man there with a gun.
Maybe he's the bird scarer. I was hit full in the face by a rook once. Cost me the bronze.
Oh. And this will be in the end-of-year roundups. The bird scarer has just fired his gun into the air and scared all of the competitors. They've all run away. Around the track.
It's just like one of those races. With the people.
And they're all in a terrible hurry to get somewhere. And let's hope that's a long way away, because we've got to go to Giles, who's at the thing with the people throwing the stick. Giles.
You join us at the outdoor range for what promises to be one of the highlights of the day, the mountain biting.
French hopeful Jean-Paul Jean-Edouard Jean-Marie Jean-Christophe Jean-Jean Gentilhomme takes on the Spanish champ Consuela de Diego del Dino de Dante de Dario.
Quite a mouthful.
As is the event.
Worth reminding our viewers not to try this at home.
Quite. These people have years of training.
And very little brain. And they're off!
Sinking their teeth into the mountain.
Now, these are tournament-standard mountains for this class of event, a pair of weighted granite outcrops sourced from the Swiss Alps. Very hard on the molars.
Daddario clearly struggling there.
And there it is! Gentilhomme, the gentleman of mountain biting, has won.
And to think his critics said he'd bitten off more than he could chew this time.
Not that he'd chew the lump of granite in his mouth, of course. That's against the rules of mountain biting.
That'd wipe the smile off your face.
My favourite food, it's baked beans. So it's baked beans. It's baked beans. My favourite food is baked beans.
I'll eat anything, me. The other day I even ate horse. That's H-O-R-S-E. Oh, I love alphabet spaghetti.
My favourite food is baked beans.
My favourite food is mixed salad, as long as it's mixed with chips.
It's baked beans. It's...
Did you just push him in?
Sorry.
I got splashed. There's chlorine in that water. Have you got any idea what that can do to a man's fake tan?
No.
It can wash it clean off. I'm going to have to go and get a respray because of you, so I hope you're happy. Right, that's it. Everyone out. I mean it, all of you. I've got to go and get my tan resprayed. Blame him. It's all his fault. Unbelievable.
Hey there, I'm Chad Stevens. And yep, I think it's time-saving time. Oh, yeah. Planting your own vegetables is super ace healthy, but it can take ages. Save time by buying your vegetables from the supermarket and then planting them. Soon you can pick potatoes straight from the tree. Bonus tip, I can save time by not eating this. Job done!
Ow!
It's the number one collectible card collecting phenomenon that's sweeping the nation, although admittedly not very fast. It's time to collect the Brian Butterfield Premier Football Backroom Staff Collectible Card Collection. So, get collecting.
There's the groundsman, kit washer, boot polisher, toilet cleaner, miscellaneous meat sandwich seller.
All the unsung heroes of your favourite football teams, without whom your Saturdays, Sundays, Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and sometimes Thursdays and Fridays just wouldn't be the same.
Accounts tabulator, coach driver, reserve team coach driver, fluorescent guard, football net knitter. There are over 20,000 to collect.
Collect them all. And swap them with your friends.
I'll swap you Manchester United's physio for the night watchman at the Arsenal Stadium.
Brilliant. I only need the lawyer who finalises the paperwork for the sponsorship deals, and I've got myself the complete set.
Keep your collection in pristine condition in this Brian Butterfield commemorative cabinet.
Got.
At least a half hour of fun.
These cards are a must-have for football fans. Everywhere. Available now in all newsagents willing to sell them. Collect now!
From the people who bought you Table Football comes the ultimate challenge. Table Water Polo. You'll only be playing one game this year because it's impossible to score.
Oi, no spinning. This is rubbish.
Table Water Polo, from the company that bought you Table Ski Jumping, Table Orienteering and Table Husky Racing. All games still in stock. We haven't sold any. Table Water Polo. Water not included.
Do you know which one of these is the badminton lights?
That one.
Ah! Yeah. Doesn't feel right.
No. Oh, that one. There, definitely.
Ah. I don't think this is right either. Oh, hang on, it's those ones. Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
No, that's too floppy. Oh, is it that one?
That's football.
That one?
Hockey.
Is it that one?
Volleyball.
Is it that one?
Chess.
That one?
Trampolining.
That one?
Cat racing.
That one?
That's professional forward rolling.
Is it that one?
That's a helipad.
Oh, it's that one.
Yes.
Here we go. Badminton time. Sorry. Look, I'm going to look in the book. That one.
Oh.
Okay.
Awesome.
Well, that's badminton.
Right.
Time's up!
Need to set up for basketball. Same time next week?
Duchner of Germany. This throw could take him onto the medal board. Quite a character. His little rituals, little lift of the shirt. Pretending he can't find the hammer. Ah, there it is. Nice to see that even under this sort of pressure, these athletes have a human side. Weighing up the hammer, getting the measure of it. Go for the handle end. That's the regulation grip. Here we go, taking the strain. Whirling round and round. Oh, it's a blur. And there it goes. It must be 3-4 inches. Absolutely incredible. And he's happy with that. He'll be looking forward to a silver medal, and because he didn't wet himself, some chocolate buttons and a tiger sticker.
Penalty red! Yes!
Come on!
That was such a surprise. I haven't even prepared a speech. Firstly, I'd like to thank my central midfielder, Jermaine. If it hadn't been for him diving in the box and rolling around like he'd been attacked by a swarm of angry wasps, that penalty would never have been possible. This is for you, mate. I'd also like to thank the rest of the team. Couldn't have done it without you boys. Well, maybe not Andy. Terrible player. I'd like to thank my beautiful girlfriend, Letitia. Oh, sorry, Janine. I've got a new girlfriend. I probably should have told you earlier. But you know how... Oh! It's finished. What happened, lads?
You lost. 2-1. Thanks for nothing, mate.
Can I still keep this? I take that as a yes.
I'm a vegetarian, but I love hot dogs. I mean, I figure it's okay because there's no real meat in them.
What are my favourite foods? I need to call my agent. Hello, Terry. Yeah, it's me. What foods am I endorsing at the moment? Right, got you. Whatever he says.
Hey there, Chad Stevens here with even more of my super awesome time-saving tips. I've decided to do this bit really fast so you can save even more time.
Going on vacation takes ages. There's aeroplanes, taxis, buses, hostels, tents, luggage, rows about who lost the passport, and all that takes time. Such a drag. So why not save time by doing a staycation? Yes, holiday at home. Buongiorno, senoritas. This is so awesome. You guys have saved so much time.
I wanted to go to Spain.
Shh. Another great job. Tres bien, tres fast.
Can I go now, Mom?
No.
Yeah, I take my sport pretty seriously. If I'm watching it on television, I like to get the best equipment I can. I want quadraphonic wraparound sound, I want 60-inch plasma, the works.
Yeah, well, I reckon we've got exactly what you're after. This is the latest in 4D TV. It's like you're at the actual stadium itself.
4D?
Absolutely. Put these on and try it for yourself.
I'll believe it when I see it.
Here we go. See? Incredibly realistic. Well,
I don't really like motorsport.
All right, check this out.
And it's a huge kick from the fly half there, soaring up the field. Well, the pack are giving chase, but they're...
So what do you reckon? Does it look like they're coming at you?
Nah.
They're trying everything they can today. No tricks have been left in the dressing room. Oh, would you look at that?
No, that was quite impressive.
Yeah. Let's try another channel.
Couldn't be closer in this. The last round as the world record javelin thrower starts his run-up. And there it goes. Oh!
Where are you going?
He's done it.
It comes with a lifetime guarantee.
Sorry, miss. I can't do weights today. I've got a note. I've been having dizzy spells and I'm not allowed to strain myself.
Yeah, miss. I can't do it either. Do magic spells, and I'm not allowed to brain myself.
And you join us here at the whatever this is. Some people there in a hurry. And there's the woman from the country with the blue flag in easily the biggest hurry, closely followed by the one who looks a little bit like the old Doctor Who.
Coming up behind them, it's the woman with the hair, and coming up in the rear, the one who was on sport relief. In fact, it looks as though she's trying to beat the woman from the country with the blue flag to wherever she's going, possibly to catch a plane to the country with the blue flag.
Or a boat.
That'd be good. You're an expert on boats.
I'll be ready.
Sorry! Soup's ready, Chef.
Right, well, have you tasted it? Because if you haven't tasted it, you won't know if you've seasoned it properly. Give it here. Right, it needs more salt.
More salt, Chef?
Right. It's not bad, actually. Yeah. Mmm. You could lay off the salt next time.
Leg of lamb's ready, Chef.
Oh, don't mind if I do.
Welcome back to the world's weakest man competition, and it simply couldn't be more exciting. With me is Derek Featherstone, former world's weakest man winner. Derek, who's your tip for the title?
It's too heavy. Well, for me, it's a two-horse race.
Still got it, Derek. You've still got it.
Come on, Monty, you need some fresh air and exercise. Take the dog for a walk.
Okay. Fetch.
love swimming, but sometimes it can be an awful lot of bother. So here's a simple shortcut I use when I can't be faffed to actually go swimming. You'll need one of these. It's a wet towel, and I simply rub it in my hair. There. And for that post-exercise glow, rosy cheeks. You'd think I'd just done 20 lengths, whereas in fact, I've just been in bed finishing off a fried breakfast. Mmm. Sausages. You've been swimming? Oh, yes. And that's how to cheat at swimming.
My favourite food is shepherd's pie, but I have to say that because Mum makes them. She's over there. All right, Mum? They're disgusting.
I can't go. Checkmate.
I have checkmate. I can't go.
No, checkmate.
I have checkmate. I can't go.
Checkmate.
I still can't go.
Excuse me. Anybody? please. I'm afraid of heights. I want to get down. Please.
More. 180!
I mean, look at the quality of that picture. It's like you're at the actual match.
Oh, and he's knocked that one for six. That's sailing through the air. Oh, he's been caught out! Unbelievable! What a
fantastic
finish!
Champion!
Well, for some reason, he's still holding onto the ball, though. The game really can't continue without the ball.
Oh, sorry.
What are you doing? You're going to have to pay for that now!